Many insects of the order Diptera that place their eggs in fruits are known by the generic name of fruit flies. Vinegar flies of the genus Drosophila, also known as domestic fruit flies, are common pests in the home, going after overripened fruit and vegetables. But in the home orchard, the greatest threat comes from fruit flies of the genus Ceratitis, like the Mediterranean fruit fly. These highly invasive species, known by the scientific name Ceratitis capitata, is one of the world's most destructive fruit pests and is endemic to sub-Saharan Africa. This pest has a high dispersive ability, a relatively wide temperature range, and it's established in many parts of the world. It's considered eradicated from North America, but the threat of introduction is always present through imported fruits and vegetables. The females are attracted by a wide range of cultivated fruits and some vegetables, ripe or unripe. Medfly, as it is commonly known, infests more than 250 vegetable hosts worldwide. The damage is caused by larvae-infested fruits or stung fruit. The female, using its ovipositor, stings the fruits to lay their eggs. Larvae may develop from the eggs, depending on when they are laid and the fruit type. For instance, apples can be stung when they are unripe, but the eggs will only hatch when the fruit ripens. Adult medflies are active in the winter when temperatures exceed 54 degrees Fahrenheit, 12 degrees centigrade. In the spring, as temperatures increase, adults emerge from the ground and become active. If control is not started and populations start to be reduced, they will cause lots of damage later in the summer. Medflies prefer soft-fleshed fruits, like peaches or apricots, to lay their eggs. But if populations start to increase, competition will make them turn to any available fruits, even hard-fleshed ones. When the ovipositor pierces the fruit skin, batches of eggs are laid in the hole. These will hatch in 2 to 4 days with summer temperatures. In the summer, the resulting larvae will turn into new adults in 28 days and new infestations will occur. Stinging the fruits will introduce bacteria that will cause decay. The hatched larvae will feed on the decaying tissues, growing quickly. With summer temperatures, in just 12 days, the larvae will reach maturity. When fully grown, they will stop feeding and jump out of the fruit, burrowing into the soil and turning into brown pupae. These will hatch into adults in 12 more days. The adult maggots are white, with a flat pointed head, and at this stage of the life cycle is when they are most likely to be seen. You can make your own fruit fly traps by using empty water or juice bottles. For that, you will have to drill or burn at least 4 holes on opposite sides of the bottles. The holes should be placed slightly above the middle of the bottle. I like to open the holes just below the shoulders of the bottle. If using a heated tool to open the holes, it's probably better to choose one that has the right diameter for the job, roughly 6 to 8 millimeters. The one I am using here doesn't, and if I insert it too deep, it will make holes that are too big, like this. With some attracting mixes that can lure bees, this might end up killing pollinating insects. So, keep the hole small, as the fruit flies are tiny. Many fruit fly lure recipes are available on the web. I prefer to use diammonium sulfate, an odorless white crystalline salt, commonly used as a soil fertilizer. You can make your own recipe by mixing a few ingredients like wheat germ, honey, sugar, jam, vinegar, beer, or fruit juices. I like to use this type of lure because it's cheap, very effective, and it seems to attract mainly fruit flies and not other useful insects. You just have to add water to this salt and mix well. I use roughly a full tablespoon per cup of water, but even much smaller concentrations will work well. I make enough mix to use on the bottles I will be hanging at that time. ~120 grams of this stuff will be enough to make about 1 liter of attractant. Before filling the bottles, plan some form of hanging them near the trees. I like to use a soft wire wrapped around the bottle's neck. Pour the prepared mix inside the bottles. A small amount per bottle is usually enough. I fill less than 1/3 of the bottle. Removing the labels first is probably a good idea, as they can deter flies or attract young children. Another good idea is painting around the holes with a bright color. Yellow, it's the best option. This will focus the fly's attention in that area, making the entrance holes easier to find. Remember that after a few weeks, you may need to refill the bottles to maintain the mix effective and to compensate for evaporation. Some commercial bait mixes are available for fruit flies. Check to see if they aren't pheromone-based baits, as only males will be attracted to these mixes. You can hang the traps on branches of the fruit trees. Traps should be placed between 1.5 and 2 meters of height. Around 5 feet will be fine. Place the trap so it can be partially shaded. A more exposed trap will also catch flies, but it will dry up more quickly in the summer. A dry trap will continue to attract a few flies, but it will be much less effective as it has to compete with ripening fruits. When inside, fruit flies can't find the holes and will end up exhausted and drowned in the liquid below. This particular attractant can catch several different species of fruit flies. Madflies seem particularly interested, and these traps will reduce fruit damage as both male and female are attracted. Many Drosophila or common fruit flies will also be lured into these traps. So, you can even use this approach in your home to reduce common fruit fly populations. Remember to keep the holes quite small, as these fruit flies are tiny insects. Making the holes small is essential if you have bees nearby and use sugar or honey-based attractants. I made the holes in these last two bottles way too big. Just see the size of the hole compared to the size of the madfly, which is bigger than the common fruit fly. Remember that the range of attractiveness of these traps is just a few meters. So, in the home orchard, place enough traps to cover all the fruit trees. Maintaining a good orchard hygiene is key to achieve better results when fighting these pests. For control to be effective, it is essential to dispose of fly-infested fruits. Fallen fruit should be gathered and disposed of properly. There are several methods you can use, like placing them in a black plastic bag in full sun, so the larvae is killed. Another is placing all the fruits inside a container with water, as larvae emerging from the fruits will drown. Avoid burying the fruits, as larvae can survive and develop into adults. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, and share the video to support the channel. Click the bell to receive notifications of new videos.